of got it set up so.
This up here recording. I just can't, my back can't take this one anymore.
Is it running?
I'm gonna get on my card over there.
Is it running?
Yeah, it's running.
Make sure we don't bump it.
Thank you. tools.
I'm gonna say, Bob, I'm 95% of the games since Penn State, my head coach, and make good, great adjustments at halftime. They just get the rest. That's what gets you in the rest.
Thank you.
Yeah.
He's the guy that's...
He's down there. He said his back couldn't take it.
I'm crazed. I'm just crazed.
Well, yeah. That's every day.
I know, but this week has been especially crazy.
It's just different degrees of
it. It is that. I have to present tomorrow. I've been working hard and getting my presentation ready for like 80 people. So, tomorrow at Miami Valley.
What, are you giving a seminar?
I'm giving a part of a, it's like a 4-hour con-ed, but I have like an hour. Like
a
45 minutes of it.
Is that just something once a year?
They just asked me if I would do it. I'm so damn stupid. I can't. I don't know how to say anything. After I said yes, I was like, I'm going to mock myself. I don't know how to say anything. I got Claire as the senior. What am I doing? So I've been busting it, trying to get it all ready. It'll be good. I mean, I like to do it.
Once you get going, you'll probably get along.
Come up. Being hit by 3 or 4, can't get the seven there. In the ballpark of that, he trimmed up my ass strip. Looks real good. Got all the dead out of it. He trimmed the box elder off. Got it out of my hard maples. Then he went around back and got a soft maple.
He didn't take one down.
No. And then he did another box elder.
Does he do it by himself, or does he?
He has a helper, and then he uses a bucket.
Does he got a company, or is he just kind
of... Yeah, he does. He's over there on Thomas Road. Kind of close to that land of illusion. But he don't climb them. I like when Terry White was doing it. He was an arborist. And he'd climb the trees. He's a kid I had to do my ambulance.
Now, you said he sold all the stuff. He probably did some stuff.
Yeah, he don't do it.
The problem with that is by the time you get somebody out there...
I'm going to say, he charged me $1,300 or $1,500. I'm going to have to go back and look.
There's no trees anymore, so that's when I asked that guy. I mean, they didn't do that much of that big out. They got me back to the fir. It's an evergreen, that's a good effect. And they cut the underbrush out, and they got the damn... honeysuckle out of there and shit, because I said, well, what'd you do to that? Because I really couldn't tell.
Where's that?
The big evergreen in the back between mom and dad and dog.
When was that? When'd you have that done?
Well, I mean, he was talking about doing it. But I didn't see that.
He did spend quite a bit of time on the asteroid and in the box there. And after he got everything cut to my fireplace. See, he cut everything up. He left it to my house for me to process for the fireplace. They took the brush. Then he went around back and he trimmed up the box elder that's dying on the garage side. It's outside of the house. On
still
the
got some life in it though.
Yeah, it'll boost back out. But he got all the dead out of it, so it don't fall on the carpet. And then he went to the one that's grown into my dog room. The date made a fragrance in the head. Then he trimmed the one back that grew into my dog room. I should have cut that tree down a long time ago before it started going into the panel of the dog room, but it's grown into the metal. So, but he trimmed that up and got it. It's not hanging over in Clayton, Georgia.
Not that big a tree,
is it? It's a huge tree. But he cut some of the sprigs.
She done?
Body achy.
Aches from playing or aches from other?
Probably got a bug.
And then her right knee, she tweaked 2 games ago.
Is that the hurt one?
Yeah, that's her surgery.
How'd she hurt it?
I didn't see it happen at Melbourne. It was in the third set, and she said she twisted it funny. She ran in the mats or something. So I'm like, I don't know, but I don't think it's torn. I just think she tweaked it and it's sore.
So you're kind of glad this is the last one then, because of all that?
They've only won 3 games in 2 years.
She's only what?
Three games.
Three regular seasons
this year.
In 2 years. They opened.
I thought they won. More.
Maybe. I don't know. I can't keep track of it. It's pointless.
You know, if they were top notch, it'd be a little different.
That one thing about Barry Sanders, that thing's pretty good.
What is it?
Everybody thought he was a dick because he just left. And he kind of left them high and dry. But really, when you listen to him, it made a lot of sense. He didn't like the microphone in his face. He never spiked the ball. He didn't like the attention. So whenever it came time, he thought, well, I'm just going to get the hell out of here. So he went overseas, London or somewhere, and they were like, but he came back and explained it all. He just had enough. But anyway, his kids were with him, and they kept asking him questions. And he finally said, the one kid said, well, if you'd have been on a good team, do you think you'd have gone back? And it sounded like, you know, if they weren't losing all the time, he probably would have. If they thought they could make a run at the Super Bowl, he probably would have done it.
Ooh, no,
that one time ago,
touches the line too, man.
One time he was in college or something, he was going to do an interview, he went out the back.
That's funny.
Got some pretty good volleys this year. That's a pretty good.
What are the right things to put your heads around your head? Are those like knee pads?
Is that a knee pad? Is that a knee pad? It just goes up high?
She wears her knee pads down low.
No, I mean, is that a knee support thing? Is that out?
If it doesn't touch the line, it's out.
I mean, he goes up, it's out, right?
Yeah.
Well, this is in.
Okay. I mean, you're over here.
Yeah. You can't see.
That thing she have on trying to support her.
Black thing. She's taped. I taped her in that. She's got
that. Why are we leaving such big open gaps right there in the middle? Man, we're right there. got some decent logs and he'd give you a little better price. And he'll cut them logs 20 inches long. I'll come take the logs out of them. If he'll cut, you know. If he'll cut, that'd be less work for them. All we got to do is leave a 20-inch log there and I'll come get them. He might take off $200 or $300. Anything about this big around and bigger, I would take home. See, that's one reason why John, I think his name's John Smith, gave me a pretty good deal because he didn't have to, you know, although he might have had to make more cuts. Because in other words, I forget how big of a log they can stick in that shredder. But I mean, I think it'll eat logs this big, but probably not this big. So they would still have to cut them up small enough for them to lift them, but they may not have to cut them up quite as many times. But anyway, I kept all the wood, so.
I mean, you could say, hey, my brother mentioned that you take any of the logs. You cut them about 20 inches long and just leave the logs. Or if he just left them in lengths, I'd try to come and cut them that way and get them out of there. See where she just bumped it over? They should have tried to push it up there, but she just bumped it right back over. Well, I mean, if she would have slammed it, it'd been one thing, but she kind of just bumped it up.
Have some frost next week, but I think we'll be in the week it warms back up in the 70s. It's going to be warm this weekend too. And he's going up the cold water help start taking the dock up. Asked me if we want to go. I said, I think I got mom Sunday. So. She had a pretty good night last night.
Margaret, you didn't start working on next week's yet anyway.
No, I'll be down there tomorrow.
I gotta go pick the letter up, sign the letter, and they're gonna fax it tomorrow.
Sure hope that works. Jeez,
they'll call me and say, this thing they said has nothing to do with your mom's vehicle. And I said, yeah, they act like they were just sending you a little guide for you to go by. And I said, I read the first couple of lines and thought, well, that doesn't sound like anything to do with turning the car in. But the guy, and I said Alan, his name's on the lease form, because I was using it as a note scratch pad. He's their go-between their risk department and me, and I'm the go-between my mom and you. And they said, yep, it's got to be a letter from you with your seal.
And it's stating
that everything that I sent them is the real deal, and that I don't want to take over the payments of the car, and you need to come get the vehicle.
I know they won't do it, but they should reimburse you since you first started trying to get it paid.
Yeah, and the insurance, too.
Because they say you're not.
So I'll have a charge tomorrow for this. And
yeah,
I'm just
how much
gonna,
is it?
I'll let you know. I'll use a debit card. I'll use a debit card. And then you guys got the picture of the insurance, right?
I knew she had one.
Yeah, she has an insurance, so whatever fees come up when she finally passes, we're going to use that.
Right. I mean, to however far
that'll
takes
take us.
Right. Because it's only a 10,000, but what's
looked to me like she only got like 70, 80, 100.
I know, that's what you started.
Yeah, but then by the time you get the funeral.
Well, it looked to me like, I thought most of the funeral stuff was supposed to be paid for.
Well, the
mausoleum.
But I don't know about all the...
Did you happen to ask her what she wanted to be buried in? Did you get those purple things?
She told me, right?
No, I just put them all the purple dresses together, and I said maybe you could take, you know, show her.
Yeah, I thought you.
I'll do it tomorrow.
I thought she picked it out. You said purple.
It seemed like I remember something about purple. Not all I remember. Yeah.
She wanted me and Marlo told her,
your car's got to go, and she went, my car.
Same thing
she said
last time. That's the short-term memory issue
again. Yeah.
And as far as us telling her it's okay to go, she doesn't even remember we had this.
Well, you don't have to tell her the car. She won't even notice.
No, she's not even going to notice.
She ain't been in the garage for 3 or 4 months.
Maybe she got, somebody pushed her through her chamber.
The car could be
outside. That time she don't open her eyes.
The car could be outside if it were.
Hanging on, just blowing my mind. It's like, wow. I mean, you're almost an invalid. She's almost totally bedridden. Some people live like that.
I guess she could hang on like that another year. I'd really rather have not have to put us through that. But it could easily happen, I guess. I don't know.
I mean, I think she could have got some better care. She wouldn't be in this condition, but they could have got rid of that UCL. They kept following up. Learned something about it 3 years ago. 2 years ago.
So you start back to work Monday, so you won't...
Sunday.
Now, is that a partial? Would you work a partial day term?
Sunday, Monday.
On Sunday, Monday, and then you have your day off. 2 days.
So I stay with mom on Tuesday night, so that'll be...
And then you'll start back to work second?
Second, third, yeah.
Got a giant gap. We leave a giant gap. Got to move your feet. I think she couldn't do it. Yeah, well, I know.
She finally got a jersey with her number on it, huh?
They found it.
Because it's pink. The pink one was there, and that's for breast cancer. The white one she has, the red one, they never did buy her.
What happened to them?
You've been 18 the whole damn
year. I know, but what happened to 14? Was there ever a 14?
Yeah, for 3 years she was 14, and she, nobody knew what happened to the
baby. And they couldn't buy another one?
One
of them deals like everything.
That's a
good business. Yeah.
You know, so that
Bill, they've been talking about shit coming here for years.
No.
Alright.
Morrison's the one that
that's just the way our society is.
He forgot he said he was
going to
do it, and then nobody ever said anything else.
That's probably down low on his list.
You gotta say,
so it hit that. It hit
if
that
it
thing.
If it just touches a pole, regardless of where it hits it.
Thank you.
One of its ran over a little green garter snake. It's about that long. It was dead in the driveway. Huh. I thought I saw it in the driveway yesterday. It was at a snake, and then I didn't think about it.
And then I cut the grass, and I was going up and back and forth trying to burn some of the leaves off. And I saw him, and I thought, oh, he must be right there.
Why is he like him?
Is he buddies with him or something?
Well, not now, but just remembers him from before, right?
You mean from when he used to work out there? What's he think he's like to build real good or something?
Yeah, I mean, he was probably doing it back then when he was 18. I don't know, 17. Pretty strong. He's on the road.
Yeah, he never does full reps.
I know the I met him, but it was just Randy and Greg and me.
Randy Marks.
Yeah, we went down that shooter. I knew Greg lived down there. We really weren't sure where to go. I said, well, how about that shooter? He said, it's so fun. So we figure as we get going, maybe get some more people.
Is it the one shooters on 747?
Yeah, those guys both live there. Because I remember Rick telling us you could see their backyard.
Well, Randy lives down.
Randy's over there, yeah. Right there by where the old paper
factory would be, yeah.
But I didn't know if Randy got back with him or not. I know Kenny said he couldn't come. And then Bogue, evidently, Greg didn't have the right number for him. So they had talked to him last night. Because Randy was like, well, that's not the right number. And then Gore said he couldn't come. Tom goes to bed, I thought at 8:30. Randy says 6:30. How can you do that? 6:30 at night. He said he called him one time at the 7:15. He said, am I interrupting something? Tom said, I'm in bed. Tom Cole.
Oh, wow.
I thought it was 8:30. I never make it a dead time. All I know is Cheryl Lead can give anybody a run for your money when it comes to sleep. Well, no, because the bed attendant don't get up for another one. And then that usually takes between an hour and 2 hours.
I don't know where you get the time.
I mean, I can't do it. I got too much shit to do.
I wouldn't want to sleep that long anyway.
Man, you know,
I
can't.
I like that.
I know better. I know better than saying anything.
Oh, well, yeah, you're going to be the bad guy.
And meanwhile, you're doing everything.
Yeah, well, that's the whole thing.
Hey, look, I can see it coming down here. I'm out here working my ass off, but I better not say anything.
All right.
Hey, you think you can help me?
Yeah.
Might be one of them meals, I don't know. But like maybe she's like, well, this is done. I do everything. She never said she does everything. She ain't never said that, but she does fucking something.
She don't go out there.
The goddamn, they're going to shrivel up, so I got to go out. Several times with Van Helsing, but this one's got Hugh Jackman. He's Van Helsing, and it's a long movie. I've tried to watch it 3 nights, but usually I'm getting a half hour. It's only 2 hours long, so I still got like 45 minutes to go. You know, well, he's trying to get Dracula, but Dracula's got the Wolfman under his control, and he's trying to get Frankenstein under his control, and he wants the key. So when all of Dracula's wives, he wants to make an immortal life. Dr. Frankenstein made Frankenstein, and you know, he brought him back to life, blah, blah, blah. So Dracula's trying to get Frankenstein so he can get all his wives and have immortality. I guess Dracula's only one lives forever.
What is he in the movie?
I don't know who the guy is that's playing Dracula.
Nobody has him.
Thank you. Hugh Jackman is Van Helsing.
What's he do to kill him?
He's a monster killer, yeah.
Four or 5 years ago.
Yeah. running that again. I was trying to figure out what day you could call for this week, but I think maybe Tuesday's only going to be in the afternoon.
I think that's kind of why you like that the other day, other than the fact that he needed
people. Well, he told me and Andy kind of had to come back for a week.
We called. I called him and said, well, come out on the boat and said, we had to work the JV game.
This time of year, you got to take the boat out the lake a little earlier anyway because it gets dark so much earlier. We took the boat off before 4:30. By the time I got home, it was like an hour and 45 minutes later. So get the boat off, get the cover on, take it to Parkside, park it, unhook it, and drive back, drop Andy off, and go home. It's almost a 2-hour deal. And it was like, I picked him up at 9:30 and we were on the water at 11:30. So it's about a 2-hour deal time to drive over there.
That's why I'm going to the lake. It just makes it where it's hard really to do. If you live on it by a lake, yeah, but.
Well, I think it still saves time than trying to hook it up to your house and drive there.
It's less hassle to do it that way, but it's still pretty time consuming.
Right. This will probably be the last one.
I didn't hear today how bad that hurricane hit.
It did a lot of damage.
It went straight across like yesterday.
Yeah.
So it was a 5, then it dropped, and it was a high 3.
They said
when it hit.
They thought it was going to be a 3. It sounded like when they hit it. It was kind of like hard to predict. I don't know.
I thought it was a 3 when it hit, but it was up to a 5 for a while.
What was the other one classified as?
4. It hit a 4. It intensified right before it hit.
But then it went out and came back and was bad. I don't understand that. It seemed like it lost a lot of it.
No, it went across the state, and then it was when it got out, it was a flood in Daytona and St. Augustine. But it was out off the East Coast, but the wraparound was bringing the storm surge back in. So they were getting flooding on the east side.
I mean like North Carolina.
Oh, it worked its way up into the mountains.
Yeah, but it seemed like they went off.
They were on the east side of it, so they got way more rain, harder downpour rains. We got the easy backside of it, the light rain. But it hung around. We got 5 inches.
We got a pretty good amount. And they got no more.
I heard a few places down there got 3 feet.
Hard to cope.
That's almost a year's worth in one rain.
It's hard to cope with that. Just with these idiots we got nothing.
Come on,
guys. Make a good go of it. Their last one. Maybe that's a good one.
Is she taking college courses?
She'll have some college credits.
More than Lady had.
Lady League.
Yeah, she left.
Tuesday, she said, but did
Tuesday.
She
left Tuesday. She didn't have to leave until like 12 or 1.
So would that
but
put
she
her?
She was home for a good while. She came home Friday and then was there Friday Saturday.
Yeah.
So 12 or 9 and a half days.
So going back up at that time wouldn't be a big deal with traffic?
She kind of hit traffic, I think, when she got back in the city, but she must have missed it.
What time would it be when she'd get back? She'd have
it's
to work.
Always crappy.
What time she was on?
Now, when me and Cheryl.
I don't know, I was at work.
When me and Cheryl left there, it was shitty getting in. But when we left, we were in Lakefront for a short drive.
A nice
and it wasn't bad. It wasn't bad getting out. I mean, you got to stop and go a little bit. But.
How they are they pretty good?
I mean, they've been 11 and I don't know.
11 and 9?
11 and 9.
What, that's what Franklin is?
Yeah. Yeah!
You already have one, didn't
you? Oh, yeah, there it is.
Who knows what time did it actually start? About 10 till 7?
Probably, yeah,
because
I got here at 6:30 and then they had the
warm-up. I got here about 6:40.
JV, do any good?
Fortunately, she didn't get to that.
Huh?
Fortunately, she didn't get to that every day.
Yeah, but they tipped it, so they got
one. Oh, even though, yeah.
They tipped it. Uh-huh.
I'd change strategy. I'd say hit the sucker over. I don't care about that.
Well, just hitting it over. If you don't spike it, they can get a set up and get a nice smack on you.
I mean, they're getting out of place.
Over.
What'd they do?
Oh my God,
what'd they say?
Yeah. Oh. They called her in the news. Tough deal.
Thank you. Carlisle's pretty good.
Right? I mean, usually, yeah. Come on, man.
Got the momentum. Keep it going. Take it anyway.
Yeah.
Point's a point, for example.
Skymate's big money. Probably made close to 200 a year.
But he's younger than that, too.
Super dependent.
Is he 85? Ah. Was Scott Pebbles your age or 85 or what year?
No, wait.
87, 86. Because Leah
and Jeff were the same, 84.
84.
Suzanne was what? I thought she was 84. But she was on your basketball team. When you were a sophomore.
Suzanne was the youngest one, right?
No, I think
Scott. Maybe Scott.
Well, he talked on that thing. It had to be Scott.
Scott
was, but then at the funeral, he said that his dad said, if she was a boy, you wouldn't be here. I thought that's what he said.
If Susan was a boy, Scott wouldn't have been there.
I think Suzanne was a senior when I was a freshman.
I thought you were a sophomore because you guys were on the same team.
Yeah.
wasn't 85? Jeff
was 85, right, Preston?
84.
Yeah,
Jeff is 2 years.
I think Russ McElfresh was 85. You remember him?
Yeah. He passed.
Right? Yeah, he's the best guy out there.
What? The best guy out there?
You got a lot of meat here.
Oh, that was hard.
If I never done the chemo, I'd been better off not to do either one, hindsight. Just live and enjoy yourself till you can't go no more. He had a heart attack eventually, got so weak. Ten more of them.
Gotta get it over.
You're not gonna.
I don't know.
That looked like a scary.
Needed 10 before, man.
Is that him?